RonBellRealtor.com, part two of the Lakeside Old South Suburban area. And this goes into the kind of Thomas Creek, although a different part of Thomas Creek than you may be used to, Holcomb Ranch area as well. We just passed Evans Creek and Lakeside Drive. We're heading up Windy Hill right now. Really not much of a hill. RonBellRealtor.com, 775-750-5256. The number one real estate agent video, YouTube video channel on the internet. On your left, as we come around this corner, you'll see what's called Lover's Lookout, Inspiration Point. It's got a bunch of different names. And I think the Gen Xers, even, you know how they make it initials? I think they call it LL now, Lover's Lookout or something like that. Going back down Windy Hill, intersection of Lakeside and Davis. As I mentioned in part one, these typically are 2.5 to 10 acre parcels, although you do see an occasional acre here and there. Look at that one, huh, guys? You can see, as I mentioned in the video, how the vehicles have to go around the bike riders. I ride bike myself. I'm not a big fan of this street, although it's beautiful. But it is one of those streets where a lot of people will use this road. Even though it seems tranquil and quiet, you can see there's quite a few cars on it. Did have some, and there's a pond right there, as you see. Weeping Willows. A lot of these homes have views of the Mount Rose area, and some even have city views. And you can see the guy on the right, like I mentioned in the first video. You know, these things, to keep them pristine, they're a lot of work. Now see, this guy's kind of opted for a pond versus maybe flooding his pasture. So you can see he's kind of pretty much dried up. Wouldn't be surprised if that pond's pretty stagnant now with the ditch being closed for the last month. You can see the beautiful horses there on the right. And I apologize, it's trash day. I forgot all about that. I usually don't like to film on trash days. Nor, and this is a good tip for you real estate agents out there, because I know a lot of real estate agents subscribe to my realtor training videos, is that you generally don't want to show property if you don't have to on trash day, okay? Because obviously you don't want you know, the trash can out there. On your right, I don't know if you can see that or not, but you've got nice Mount Rose views. The area on the right, by the way, that I panned over is actually Arrow Creek and Grand View that looks down on this area. I mean, not looks down, like frowns on this area, overlooks this area. Look at that Weeping Willow. They're just not making any 425-year-old Weeping Willows. I mean, that is just amazing. And that's what you're paying for. You know, I mentioned in the first video, these things, these properties run anywhere from, say, $500,000 to on up to $2 or $3 million, depending how many acres you have and water rights and that kind of business. A lot of it's a combination of old money, old families, and retire Californians. And the caveat I mentioned in the first video, in case you haven't seen that, is if you're considering one of these properties, they are, and I live in this area, I can testify, they are a lot of work. So you're either gonna have to pay somebody to take care of your grounds, or you're gonna be out there, you know, it's a minimum 20 hours minimum a week to maintain these properties. Now, with that said, my dad was a rancher, and he ranched all the way up until, you know, late 80s. The ranching lifestyle will keep you alive and keep you healthy for a long time, so there's something to be said for that. You know, it gives you a lot of good goals in life, you know, feeding the horses, you know, doing that kind of thing, or whatever you happen to have. It's the weed pulling that I'm not a big fan of. The weed pulling and the, you know, constantly dealing with weeds. We're kind of starting to overlap the last video, but just in case this is the only one you saw, or have seen, I should say, just wanted to go ahead and finish up here. Actually, we haven't gone down the little jog street of Thomas Creek, so I'm going to take you that way. Relative to the viewer, some people like it when I talk and blab, and other people prefer that I just shut up. The thing is with music on videos is you can't put music on there because of copyright violations. Like if I had the radio playing right now, for example, which I have had before, you get a notice from YouTube that you're using copyrighted songs. So you kind of gotta either, you know, have somebody just, you can buy standard or get for free standard Creative Commons type of music. So now this actually turns into Thomas Creek right here. It's funny, I got one of those trophy wives in a Mercedes on my butt, and the speed limit's really only 25, and I'm going 35. She's all flustered talking on her hair, talking on her phone while she's doing her hair. Trophy wife in a hurry can be very dangerous on a road like this because typically they're multitasking. You know, their life is so stressful, you know, having to go to the nail salon and coffee salon and get a massage and everything else, that boy, they just, they're in a big hurry to meet their friends and have coffee or lunch or somewhere. I'm gonna let this Botox queen by real quick here. Get her off my butt. And then here's a little cutesy cutesy barn. Again, very, very typical. So now we're at the intersection of Thomas Creek and Foothill. Sure how long this is getting. Gets to be a little more dispersed right here, so heads up if you're thinking about the Foothill area. See how it's a little more open, a little more dry. I think the ditch, I want to say it kind of stops back in there. I've heard conflicting views. I know some people have ditch rights back in there and some don't. All right, so that about wraps it up. We're going to go down to Foothill, And Foothill, by the way, turns into South Meadows, so that's pretty easy to remember. South Meadows is what takes you kind of into suburbia there, the Double Diamond, Damani Ranch area, so that's pretty easy to remember. So you can actually take South Meadows off the freeway, head west, and it turns into Foothill. Foothill will then in turn turn into Thomas Creek, which in turn turns into, you know, Holcomb Ranch, Lakeside area. All right, I'm going to wrap it up. We are at the intersection of Caribou and Foothill. Ron Bell, Realtor.com, 775-750-5256. Thank you.